What's up guys, David here, and easily the most common type of request that we get here at PhoneBuff is requests for us to test more phones. And look, I'd love to test every smartphone out there, but with our tests taking up to a week to produce per phone with like the programming of the robots and everything that goes into it, there's just not enough time and resources for us to do them all. But in today's video, we are trying something new, something that I think can help us test more phones for you guys than we usually do, by partnering with our longtime channel sponsor in Wix, who by sponsoring today's video has given us the resources we needed to run 4 new battery tests on some pretty big phones that we missed out on last year. In this video, we're going over the battery test results for the iPhone 11 Pro, which, you know, we tested the 11 Pro Max and the regular 11, but we did miss out on the regular 11 Pro. We've tested the smaller Galaxy S10e, the 90Hz OnePlus 7T, and the OnePlus 7T Pro. Now, because this is more of a roundup helping us catch up with some of the phones that we've missed, the way we're gonna be doing it isn't a typical comparison, and instead, what I'm gonna be doing is adding these battery test results to our websites, and because Wix made this entire thing possible, I'll be doing a walkthrough of how we built our website using Wix in the process. All right, so we'll start off by popping into the Wix website editor, where we're immediately taken to the homepage of our website. Using this top menu, we'll switch pages to the battery test page. This page is pretty simple, as our whole website is, with a graphic banner here at the top, a text box here on the left with a short description about the test itself, and on the right, we have a video widget that doesn't just link to our channel, but it links specifically to our battery test playlist. That way, anytime we upload a battery test, the video here gets updated automatically, which is great because I know that I'd probably forget to do it. And then finally, here at the bottom is the main purpose of the page in our official battery test rankings, which is simply just a list of all the phones that we've tested so far. So I added this list and everything you see here on our websites using the sidebar menu in the editor, where you have options to do things like customizing the menus and changing the page background. But the main thing that I end up using is this plus icon that lets you add almost anything you can imagine to your site. So for the text box, I just went to text and then paragraph. For the video widget, I just went to video and then obviously YouTube. And for the main list, I just went to lists and grids and I used this specific list as my base and then I just tweaked it to look just the way I wanted. Okay, so the first phone that we'll be adding to the battery test results is the Galaxy S10e. Since we're adding a Samsung phone here, I'll just duplicate one of the existing Samsung phones so that way I don't have to change the manufacturer logo. Of course, if I wanted to change the logo if I had to, I can just hit change image on the icon and do it from there. But all we have to do for now is change the name of the phone, change the specs, which for the S10e means a 5.8 inch screen, a 3100 milliamp hour battery with a native 1080p resolution. So for the results, this Snapdragon variant of the Galaxy S10e actually lasted longer than the Galaxy S10 with the Exynos chip. But this is only by a minute with a total time of 23 hours on the dot, which considering a 16 hour standby means it had 7 hours of screen time. So not the best results, but you know, to be fair, it is a small phone with a small battery. Next phone we'll add is the 90Hz OnePlus 7T. So same thing again, we'll duplicate a OnePlus phone this time and change the name and specs, which includes a 6.5 inch 90Hz display with a native 1080p resolution and a pretty big 3800 milliamp hour battery. And the results were actually pretty surprising. Despite the 90Hz refresh rate, it did really, really well, lasting 25 hours and 34 minutes in total with a screen on time of 9 hours and 34 minutes, which places it, at least for right now, at 3rd place. So a top 3 rating for a phone that has a higher refresh rate. Who would have ever thought that a phone with a high refresh rate can have good battery? Next up is the 7T's big brother and the 7T Pro, which has a slightly larger screen at 6.7 inches, a slightly larger battery at 4,085 milliamp hours, but it also has a significantly higher 1440p native resolution, which actually ended up in it having slightly lower battery life. In total, it lasted 25 hours and 5 minutes with screen time of 9 hours and 5 minutes. So not as good as the regular OnePlus 7T, but still a pretty good result. If I had to guess, I'd say the difference was due to the differences in native resolution, but either way, I think the results on both of these phones are excellent. And then finally, the phone that I was most excited about testing for this video is that regular iPhone 11 Pro. We'll duplicate the 11 Pro Max's row here, which is the current battery test champ, beating the next best phone by almost 2 hours. But we'll go ahead and change the name to 11 Pro, and the specs with a smaller 5.8 inch screen on the 11 Pro, but obviously a much smaller battery at 3,046 milliamp hours, which resulted in a total time of 25 hours and 24 minutes, with 9 hours and 24 minutes of that being screen on time. So that's a crazy result. It's longer than the Galaxy S10 and the Note 10 Plus, which are obviously bigger phones with bigger batteries, and it actually did that with similar specs as the Galaxy S10e, which sits all the way at the bottom of our rankings. Now, last step is adding the numbered rankings to all of the results. We're just changing these little text boxes, and there you have it. I hope you guys have found this video helpful. I'm happy we're able to add 4 new results to our battery test rankings. Big thanks again to Wix for making this video possible. If you're thinking about building your own websites, you can help us out by using that first link down below in the description. And if you guys like this concept of like a sponsored video that lets us test more phones than we usually do, give this video a thumbs up. It'll help us out. You know, maybe we could do other phones like the ROG phones and the Razer phones. I don't know. But anyways, that is it for me in this video. Thank you guys for watching. And as always, I'll see you in the very next episode.